Hello everyone, myself Vijit Kumar Sabharwal and I welcome you to my YouTube channel RKS Life Sciences. So this is the part 1 of my topic Gene Expression and its Regulation. This course will be in various parts, but right now in this part I have discussed the basic concepts of operon, the structure of lac operon. The regulation will be discussed in the next video. So let's begin with this. Before we begin with gene expression, firstly, what is a gene? So they say that gene is a part of DNA that specifies a protein or RNA. किसी भी protein को या RNA को, gene is the basic unit basically. और DNA का वो part जो ultimately protein और RNA को specify करेगा. Now next thing is that they say it's not that कि हमारे cell को proteins और RNA जितने भी तरह के हैं, they are ऐसा नहीं है कि they are required all the time. Some proteins are required at some time और कुछ other proteins होते हैं which are required at the another time. But yes, there are exceptions like enzymes of TCA cycle which are present or which are constantly present in the cell. So this mechanism of gene expression जिससे कि particular protein या enzyme बनता है, ये decide करता है ultimately कोई भी phenotype या character individual में, and it is further regulated by metabolic, physiological and environmental control. Now when we talk of how this gene regulation is done in prokaryotes, so they say ki when we talk of prokaryotes and eukaryotes, to prokaryote mein sabse zyada important to ye hota hai ki ultimately jo control hota hai gene regulation ka, that is done at the transcriptional level. Otherwise they say translation control is there, but important we say sabse zyada jo mostly prokaryotic genes hain wo transcriptional stage mein hi regulate hote hain. In eukaryotes, there are transcriptional level, translational level, splicing levels, and when the mRNA is moving from nucleus to cytoplasm, so these are other phases in eukaryotes where gene is regulated. Okay, and catabolic control is done with the help of cyclic AMP, CAMP in E. coli. It has a very important role linked with glucose. We will talk about when we will be doing the lac operon regulation. Now they say many prokaryotic genes are regulated. कि ये जो prokaryotic genes हैं, इनकी regulation होती है in the form of units called as operon. Now how you define an operon? So basically operon है क्या? ये एक self-regulated gene unit है, एक ऐसी regulation वाली unit, जो gene unit जो खुद को regulate करती है according to the conditions, where one or more related genes, जहाँ पर एक से ज़्यादा, एक या एक से ज़्यादा related genes और उनकी sequences are basically वो sequences जो उन जीन्स को कंट्रोल कर रही हैं, दे ऑल वर्क टुगेदर इन अ कोऑर्डिनेटेड मैनर टू परफॉर्म अ कॉमन फंक्शन. दैट फंक्शन कुड बी ब्रेकडाउन ऑफ समथिंग, दैट फंक्शन कुड बी कैटाबॉलिक और दैट फंक्शन कुड बी एनाबॉलिक डिपेंडिंग ऑन व्हाट काइंड ऑफ ओपेरॉन इज प्रेजेंट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ वी से इट्स अ लैक ओपेरॉन, सो जनरली दैट इन्वॉल्व्स द कैटाबॉलिक पाथवे एंड ट्रिप्टोफैन ओपेरॉन विच इज फॉर द एनाबॉलिज्म, दैट इज फॉर मेकिंग समथिंग दैट इज ट्रिप्टोफैन. Now we have basically two types of operon, inducible and repressible operon. Inducible operons was basically kya hote hai, they say the genes are kept switched off. Inducible hai, so genes switched off rahenge jab tak ki koi ek metabolite inducer ki tarah kaam nahi karega aur inactivate nahi karega repressor ko. Inducible operon kya hote hai, the genes are kept switched off until a specific metabolite will come that will inactivate the repressor, and repressor will be inactivated and the operon will be switched on. In case of repressible operon, genes are kept switched on. इसमें generally genes आपके switched on ही रहते हैं जब तक कि repressor activate नहीं होता. तो यहाँ पर हमको जरूरी है कि repressor को activate कराना है in repressible operon. In inducible operon, we need to inactivate that repressor. Comparing their metabolic pathways, inducible operons are involved in catabolic pathways, breakdown pathways. Let's say lactose is broken down into glucose and galactose. Okay, and the repressible operons, they always function in the anabolic pathways, that is building pathways. For example, carisinate is used as raw material for the synthesis of tryptophan, so that is an anabolic pathway. Talking of enzyme synthesis, in inducible operon, they say that the nutrients utilized in the pathway, ki jo bhi nutrients यूटिलाइज होते हैं पाथवे में, वो ही एंजाइम सिंथेसिस को एक्टिवेट करते हैं. लेकिन रिप्रेसिबल ओपेरॉन में क्या होता है कि प्रोडक्शन इज स्विच्ड ऑफ बाय द एंड प्रोडक्ट्स ऑफ द पाथवे. इसमें जो पाथवे के एंड प्रोडक्ट्स हैं वो प्रोडक्शन को स्विच ऑफ कर देते हैं जो अल्टीमेटली एंजाइम की सिंथेसिस को रिप्रेस करता है. तो इट इज लाइक एंटागनिस्टिक वे. एंड यू से दैट फॉर एग्जाम्पल लैकोपेरोन इज योर इंडिविजिबल ओपेरॉन एंड ट्रिप्टोफैनपेरॉन इज द रिप्रेसिबल ओपेरॉन. सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट दिस ओपेरॉन कॉन्सेप्ट इन मोर डिटेल. सो यू नाउ यू नो दैट ओपेरॉन इज यूनिट ऑफ जीन एक्सप्रेशन रेगुलेशन एंड दिस थिंग वॉज प्रपोज बाई जैकोब एंड मनोर इन 1961. Now, when we talk of the components of operon, basically हमारे पास तीन components होते हैं operon के. In general, we say कि एक operon में you will be having a regulator gene, you will be having structural genes, and you will be having control elements, जिसमें कि आती हैं operator sequences. But in general, they say जब हम एक operon को define करते हैं structurally, we never take regulatory gene as a part. There is, you can say, दे आर फार अपार्ट. जो रेगुलेटर जीन है ओपेरॉन जो है उससे फार अपार्ट है. बिकॉज ओपेरॉन हम डिफाइन करते हैं स्ट्रक्चरल जीन. स्ट्रक्चरल जीन का ऑपरेटर उसका प्रमोटर. बिकॉज रेगुलेटर जीन्स दे हैव देयर ओन प्रमोटर. देयर इज अनदर प्रमोटर फॉर रेगुलेटर जीन्स. ठीक है. नाउ रेगुलेटर जीन्स व्हाट इज देयर रोल. दे आर अल्टीमेटली गोइंग टू फॉर्म प्रोडक्ट्स. Those products will recognize the control elements, that is these operator sequences, bind to it and regulate it. For example, bind करेगा उसको activity को block कर देगा, transcription रुक जाएगी. And then structural genes, they are responsible for producing enzymes. Those enzymes are involved in specific biosynthetic pathways, that could be anabolic pathway, that could be catabolic pathway, and their expression is coordinately controlled. And then you have this control element that I told you, operator sequences, which are nothing but DNA sequences, which will be ultimately regulating the transcription of these structural genes. Okay, so this is about the basic structure. To this, they say that in an inducible system, there could be a negative control or there could be a positive control. Negative control mein kya hoga? They say ki I told you that regulatory gene is another thing and the operon part is another thing when we go in their structure in detail. So what happens, they say in a negative control, what happens, regulator gene is going to synthesize a repressor. Now this repressor will bind to the regulator protein binding site. Basically jo is operon wale region ka operator tha uske sath bind karega. Now when the repressor will bind to it, ultimately the transcription will be blocked, and when the transcription will be blocked, RNA polymerase will not be able to transcribe it. So mRNA production nahi hoga. Fir is negative control mein, when you add any inducer, jab aap inducer add karte ho, that inducer binds to this repressor. Wo is repressor ke sath bind karta hai. Now this repressor inducer complex, once it is formed, that will not be able to bind to the operator of this operon. So operator site will be vacant. So wo free hoga, because repressor akela jab hai, then it is able to block the operator. When it is bound to any inducer molecule, then iski activity jo hai, that is hampered. Now the operator site is free, RNA polymerase will come, it will bind to it, and as usual it will show the transcription of the structural genes. This is the negative control. In positive control, they say what happens, that regulator gene will synthesize inactive activator. That is, us case mein kya hoga? Activator molecule usne synthesize kiya hai, but that is inactive. Usme activity hai hi nahi pehle se. Now, if it is inactive, that is not going to bind to the operator sequence. Wo operator sequence ke saath bind nahi karega. And they say that RNA polymerase cannot bind to the promoter without activator. अब activator molecule ही कोई नहीं है अगर, तो उसके activator molecule के बिना RNA polymerase cannot bind to the promoter site, and ultimately there will be no transcription. In this case also, when we add any inducer molecule, that will bind to this inactive activator and it will activate it. So we will form activator inducer complex. This is capable of binding to the operator sequence of this operon, and ultimately the structural genes will be transcribed and the respective enzymes will be synthesized. Now, in lactosapron, they say E. coli can use lactose as a source of carbon. Agar lactose jo hai wo available hai as a sole carbon source. Otherwise, agar glucose or lactose dono hi present hai inside the cell, E. coli will prefer to use glucose first as a carbon source because usko solubilize hone mein ya ultimately use mein aane mein bahut time lagta hai lactose ko. So that's why glucose is the first preferred product if we compare glucose and lactose. And important thing is that lactoferrin is induced when E. coli cells they are kept in medium containing lactose. So important ye hai ki lactose ki presence important hai. But lactose jo hai, there is another isomeric form of lactose called as allolactose, which is more important. Lactose, when it is taken up inside the cell, lactose undergoes glycosylation with the help of beta galactosidase enzyme and it is converted to allolactose. जिसमे difference होता है कि galactosyl residue जो है 6th position पे होता है rather than 4th. Okay? Because they say why allolactose? Because lactose or allolactose, out of that, if we talk of who will act as inducer, so lactose cannot bind to the repressor protein. आपको बताया था कि regulatory gene is going to form a repressor molecule. उसके साथ lactose cannot bind to that repressor and it is only the allolactose which can bind to that repressor. और वही जब वो repressor के साथ allolactose bind करेगा, then repressor molecule will be removed from the operator site और operator site से जब वो remove होगा, so ultimately transcription of structural genes will take place. So real inducer molecule is allolactose if we say, okay. And now talking of the three structural genes, हमारे पास lac Z है, lac Y है, lac A है. We will be discussing diagram ahead. lac Z will code for beta galactosidase, lac Y will encode for galactoside permease. That is permease है तो obviously permeate करेगा entry of either lactose molecule of any other isomeric form which it can take up. lac A which encodes a thiogalactoside transacetylase. इसका basically काम ये होता है कि अगर कोई फॉरेन सब्सटेंस इन द सेंस कि अगर कोई टॉक्सिक कंपाउंड एंटर कर रहा है अलोंग विद लैक्टोज तो उसको प्रिवेंट करेगा ट्रांस एसिटाइलेज एंजाइम. ओके, नाउ देयर इज वन मोर थिंग व्हिच यू नीड टू नो बिफोर गोइंग अहेड. दे से दैट अ वेरी लो लेवल ऑफ एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ लैक ओपेरॉन हैज टू बी प्रेजेंट इन द सेल. मतलब इट्स नॉट दैट कि लैक ओपेरॉन हमेशा स्विच्ड ऑफ ही रहता है. अ वेरी लो expression of lac operon is important to be present in the cell, otherwise lactose cell ke andar enter hi nahi kar payega because there will be no stimulus. So it is important ki permease ki activity, minimum activity of permease hamesha present rahegi in the cell at all times. This is very important, otherwise lactose is not going to enter the cell. And another important points to remember regarding lactosapron that it is a catabolic pathway because ultimately you know we are converting lactose with the help of beta galactosidase into glucose and galactose. It is an inducible operon, yes, because allolactose is inducing how? By removing the repressor from the operator, ultimately helping in the transcription of the structural genes. And it is under two controls, positive control of cyclic AMP and CAP and negative control of regulator gene, which you know because regulator gene agar repressor protein banayega, so ultimately there will be a negative control, there will be inhibition. And positive control kaise hota hai cyclic AMP ka aur CAP ka, that we will be discussing ahead, but you need to know for differentiating it with another operon like tryptophan. It is a catabolic pathway, it is inducible operon, it is having the positive control of cyclic AMP and CAP but negative control of regulator gene. That is about this lacoperon. So now let's see the organization of DNA sequences in the lac region of E. coli chromosome. So I told you, like, see, this is lacoperon having structural genes lac Z, Y and A. lac A encodes for thiogalactoside transacetylase, which has two functions: to remove the toxic compounds entering along with lactose, to help get rid of thiogalactoside. LACY encodes for lactose permease. What it does, it allows the uptake of the lactose into the bacterial cytoplasm. It co-transports the lactose with H positive and ultimately accumulation karata hai iska bacterial cytoplasm mein. And once it enters the cytoplasm, LACZ, which encodes for beta galactosidase, that will convert lactose into galactose and glucose. That is ribopurone work karta hai. So ultimately ye catabolic step hota hai. Theek hai? And lactose is converted to allolactose through beta galactosidase side reaction, and allolactose can be converted into this form. And ultimately, jo hai, aapke levels low ho jate hain, then cycle repeats. And then LACZ has on its upstream operator site LACO. Then it has a LAC promoter site LACB to which RNA polymerase is going to bind, and a CAP site, that is catabolite activator protein site or CAMP receptor protein site, that is a site jiska lactoferrin ko positive regulate karne mein help karta hai. And jo scenario iska rehta hai, we'll be discussing it later on, but right now you need to know ki CAP site here is present upstream to this lac promoter, and by a spacing differentially spaced we have regulatory gene. So you see, regulatory gene is not attached to this lac operon structure. Why? I'll give you reason. See, this regulatory gene is basically LACI. This is a LACI which will encode for LAC repressor, that is inhibitory molecule, jo bind karta hai LAC operator ke saath, aur ultimately transcription ko prevent karta hai by blocking this site, kyunki RNA polymerase ne yahan pe aana hai. Agar ye wali operator site blocked hai, this is not going to move further, so transcription will be inhibited. Okay, and you need to know that this regulatory gene has its own promoter, I promoter, to which we call. Okay, and this LACA has its LAC terminator here. So this is the structure of lacoperon with its various paths, and you need to know, only then you can understand the following videos. So repeating some things which I told you earlier and adding some more. So jo teen structural genes the with single transcription unit LAC, ZYA mein present hote hain, having their own promoter PLAC. Then I told you their operator site OLAC. But now you need to know that this operator site is positioned between minus 5 and plus 21. You see, pehle aata hai PLAC, then aapka operator site hai. So jo promoter ka 5 dash end hai, वहां पे जैसे ऑपरेटर साइट पोजीशन होती है किन बेसिस के बीच में, माइनस 5 टू प्लस 21. ओके, देन लैक रिप्रेसर आई टोल्ड यू हैज लैक आई व्हिच इज आल्सो पार्ट ऑफ लैक्टोज ऑपरॉन एंड इट इज सिचुएटेड अपस्ट्रीम फ्रॉम पी लैक, यू नो, क्योंकि उससे पहले प्रेजेंट होता है. गॉट इट? नाउ टॉकिंग ऑफ एलोलैक्टोज, एलोलैक्टोज आई टोल्ड यू इट इज अ डाइसैकेराइड सिमिलर टू लैक्टोज. इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ monosaccharide D galactose D glucose, and this is important, and they are linked through beta 1,6 glycosidic linkage. They say ki agar main lactose mein bolu to beta 1,4 linkage hai galactose aur glucose ke beech mein, but allolactose has beta 1,6 glycosidic linkage, and occasionally it may arise from the trans glycosylation of lactose. Ki beta galactosidase jo hai trans glycosylation ki process se occasionally isko produce kar sakta hai cell mein. It is an inducer of the lac operon in E. coli and many other enteric bacteria. Now, after that, now you know that lactose has its another kind, that is allolactose, which is the inducer molecule. They say in addition to lactose, the addition of lactose or a synthetic inducer. They say ki lactose ki addition karo ya koi synthetic inducer. For example, there is IPPG, isopropyl beta D thio galactopyranoside. Okay, they are capable of rapidly stimulating the transcription of lactose operon. Okay, so lactose, it could be allolactose, it could be IPTG, all three are responsible or capable of basically stimulating the transcription of lactose operon. But they say ki IPTG jo hai, at low concentration it enters the cell through permease. Permease ki help se hi IPTG jo hai cell mein enter karta hai. But at high concentration it can enter cell independently of lactose permease. कि लैक्टोज को जैसे परमीएज की जरूरत होती है, बट आईपीटीजी हायर कंसेंट्रेशन पे इट कैन एंटर सेल इंडिपेंडेंटली ऑफ द परमीएज एंड सब्सिक्वेंट रिमूवल ऑफ द इंड्यूसर इंड्यूसर मॉलिक्यूल. लेट्स सी येलो लैक्टोज है, आईपीटीजी है, सो अल्टीमेटली सब्सिक्वेंट रिमूवल ऑफ द इंड्यूसर दैट विल लीड टू इमीडिएट इनहिबिशन ऑफ इंड्यूस्ड ट्रांसक्रिप्शन. बिकॉज आपको पता है कि जो फ्री लैक रिप्रेसर है वो रैपिडली ऑपरेटर साइट को ऑक्यूपाई कर लेता है जैसे ही इंड्यूसर मॉलिक्यूल वहां से जाता है. दिस इज व्हाट आई टोल्ड यू द केस ऑफ द नेगेटिव कंट्रोल एंड द पॉजिटिव कंट्रोल. बेसिकली नेगेटिव कंट्रोल का सिनेरियो है ये, जिसमें कि रिप्रेसर मॉलिक्यूल के साथ जब इंड्यूसर बाइंड करेगा तो वो उसकी एक्टिविटी को हैम्पर कर देगा एंड दैट इट विल बी फ्री फ्रॉम द ऑपरेटर साइट एंड अल्टीमेटली प्रोटीन्स विल बी सिंथेसाइज्ड. ओके, सो इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो वी विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट योर regulation by the help of lac repressor and cap, that is catabolite activator protein. So that's all for now. Thank you.